Hi, I'm Zoran Kapelan. I'm professor of water systems engineering at the University of Exeter in United Kingdom. And I'm here representing today the EWRI Water Distribution Systems Analysis History Project. The purpose of this project is to document the history of water distribution systems analysis. And an important part of this project is a series of interviews we are conducting with a number of people who work in this area. Our interview today is with Professor Marco Franchini from the University of Ferrara in Italy. He has been at the forefront of water distribution systems analysis since the 90s and continues to make significant contributions in the field. His work in academia has contributed to a number of topics, as you will find out shortly from him. This interview is being conducted on the 3rd of September 2015 as in Leicester, as part of the CCWI conference. Yes, the first question for you, Marco, is you have been working in the field of distribution systems analysis for quite a long time. Can you please tell us how did you first get involved in this field?
Thank you for your question, Zoran. And well, I got the position of a researcher, or using a more international terminology, assistant professor, when I was 29 in 1983 at the University of Bologna, where I worked for 15 years, mainly in the research field of hydrology. There I had the opportunity also to work with Ezio Todini, who was indeed my tutor for my thesis at the University of Ferrara. However, in these 15 years, I have been working mainly on hydrology, technical hydrology, rainfall runoff modeling, flood forecasting, extreme value distributions analysis, regionalization techniques, and so on. Parametrization of the rainfall runoff models. At the end of this period, in 1998, I got the position of associate professor in Ferrara, where I had the opportunity to work with a very dear friend of mine, Paolo Lamberti. At that time, Paolo was working on water demand analysis. Indeed, he was setting up an instrumentation systems in Castelfranco Emilia, which is a small town near Bologna. And I had the opportunity to begin to work with him on this topic. Unfortunately, indeed, very unfortunately, he was ill and he died shortly after. So I was asked by my university to continue, to continue this project. And so I finished the installation of these instrumentations in Castelfranco Emilia for measuring water demands at residential level, at a relatively high aggregation level and a very high aggregation level. This project lasted about 1 or 2 years. At the end of this period, we had a lot of data. And the normal question, the obvious question, what can I do with all this data? And the point is that at the beginning of the 90s, I used to go to Newcastle upon Tyne to work with Professor Andrew O'Connell, mainly in the topic of hydrology again. But at that time, I had the opportunity to study the work written by Coppert White on Nemascott models for rainfall modeling. Now, two things together. Modeling for rainfalls. Buchberger, at the end of the 90s, produced a paper on how to represent the water demand at the residential level using a Poisson process, which is not very far from the Nemascott formulation. And so I had familiarity with this rainfall representation, and I decided to represent, to study, to interpret, to filter these data through a Nemascott model. Try to understand the scale effect from residential level, small aggregation level, high aggregation level, and particularly the effect of the scale, time scale. this set of instruments gave me also another opportunity, because at the beginning of the 2000 years, in 2001, I was contacted by Derek Jameson from Newcastle, Aportine again, because he was a friend of Andy O'Connell. And since I had this set of instruments, I was asked to join a EC project called PowerDIMA, Potable Water Distribution Management. And in this project, we were asked to set up a forecasting model with a lead time up to 24 hours. Again, this data, these systems, was very useful to set up and to start with this activity. Indeed, these are the first steps, my first steps, in the water distribution systems. And we are at the beginning of the 2000 years.
Okay, thank you. I remember actually reading quite a few good papers coming out of that PowerDIMA project, and I still encourage my researchers to do the same. Now, you have been collaborating, I believe, with Tom Wolski and a few other people during your career. Can you tell us a little bit about this collaborative work? You know, how do you find this? You know, what did you get out of it?
Well, I think I can mention about my collaboration, certainly the collaboration with Ezio Todini, who I met as a student when I was a student in 1978, some years ago. He used to teach hydromechanics. He gave a peculiar type of teaching, because at the end of that course I could able to program in Fortran language the flood routing model based on the characteristic methods. And after that, Ezio asked me my willingness to have a grant at the IBM Center in Pisa. This was in 1978. I was a student, I was 24, and at that time I didn't know anything about even the meaning of the word statistics. In 3 months, I had to study all the stochastic processes represented by ARMA, ARIMA, ARMAX, fractional Gaussian noise, Brown motion. It was a full immersion period. And that was the initial period for collaborating with Ezio. I had the opportunity to work with him for many years, because he was professor at the University of Bologna, where I was a researcher, assistant professor, since 1983. And all the works I developed with Ezio are mainly concentrated on hydrology. Rainfall models, for example, I think I could say I gave a good contribution to the Arno model, to the PAB parabolic and backwater model with lateral contribution, with lateral inflows, and many other things. Then, when I began to work on water distribution systems, well, collaboration with Ezio temporarily at the stop, but indeed is continuing right in this period. I'll tell you in a few minutes. But in this period, I have had the opportunity to work with Tom Wolski. I found this collaboration very exciting, because he has a definitely different mentality or way of thinking with respect to an academic person like me. And in fact, all the work we have done on multi-phasing optimal design, the discussion was funny, because I used to work on theoretical aspect basically with my co-author Enrico Creaco. You know very well him, because he has worked for at least 1 year in Exeter. But as we obtained some numerical results, well, the discussion with Tom's was always and mainly on the meaning, on the practical meaning of the numbers. So he didn't like to discuss about the theoretical aspect, but the consequence, the practical consequence that this idea could have on practical results. And this has been a very exciting and very useful for developing research. Other collaboration. I want to recall this this funny situation. It was in Perugia, to CCWI 2013. I co-authored the paper with Enrico Creaco about the use of the resilience index formulated by Ezzetotini for considering the reliability of water distribution systems. But unfortunately, I may say, we used the modified version of the of this resilient index. And Ezio didn't like it all. He was present during our presentation. He didn't like it all, and he highly criticized, as he used to do, directly after soon after the presentation. We tried to sustain our thinking, our reasoning, and the discussion continued even after. But this was useful because we had the opportunity. He criticized our approach, but he realized that we had some reason for modifying. So we had together an idea, and we wrote a paper together, Creaco, Ezio, and me, on this modified resilient index. And this has been the opportunity to work with Ezio again in this last period.
Okay, thank you very much for sharing those experiences. In the distribution systems analysis community, we periodically organize these battles or these competitions. We started in 2006, I believe, in Cincinnati, and then we had a number of these, typically around the problems of distribution system design and so on. And you have done really well in those competitions, which is really commendable. How do you do it?
Well, I must say I had the opportunity, or I was so lucky, to win two battles, one on calibration and the other on optimal management. The last one in Berry last year, and the other it was in Tucson in 2010. Calibration problem. Well, what can I say about this? First of all, to obtain these results, you must believe in what you are doing. So, we because the first battle was performed together with Stefano Alvisi, and the second battle was performed with Stefano Alvisi again, because he is working in Ferrara with me, and Enrico Creaco. In that period, Enrico Creaco was working at the University of Ferrara. Well, two basic concepts. First concept is to believe in what you are doing. So to consider the battle as a field research, I mean as a real research, to give time, effort, and all your mind to these reasonings necessary for formulating the solution. The second aspect was not to think to this battle as a mathematical problem, but as an engineering problem. So I still remember the long discussion we had together in a group of this brainstorming on interpreting the system, the physical systems, before doing any optimization. I say optimization because also calibration is a sort of optimization. You have to minimize some objective function with respect to the measurements. But what we tried to do was to obtain the results, good result, believable result, engineering result, manually. Only after that we use some genetic algorithm, some technicians we have already developed in other fields. But this was the basic point. Believing in what we are doing, so dedicating a lot of time on doing that, not at the end of the day after doing all the other things. Dedicating times for that and thinking to an engineering problem.
Okay, thank you, Marco. One final question for you. Given your past, what you have already done in the field and your current experience and expertise, what do you see as the key challenges for the future in terms of research in water distribution systems analysis area?
Well, I used to study forecasting model, and I used to say future is unknown. But said this, I think many things, but two aspects for me are fundamental. And this derives also from my experience I have with agency and industries. Information communication technology has to be considered as a basic subject in the future, because agency in the civilized world, I mean Europe, United States, are modifying their systems using a lot of information communication technology. Indeed, at the moment, they are using it without knowing deeply the potentiality of these instruments. And what maybe we have to do, being as hydraulic engineering, is how to transform all these data collected and managed and transferred in hydraulic information, because there is the world of informatic engineering, which is another field, but our field is how to transfer this information in something that has hydraulic meaning. This is a fundamental aspect, I think, that will call for a lot of researchers to deal with this topic. The other is certainly the quality aspects of the water, because this aspect requires a lot of money. I mean, at least in my experience, agency like ERA, which is the utility managing the water distribution systems in Emilia-Romagna, gave a lot of importance to this aspect, because they are investing, they are putting a lot of money in treating water. And these are the two aspects mainly I think we have to consider. The interaction between information communication technology and water distribution systems, and quality, particularly in the civilized world. Another story, of course, is for emerging countries, where I think we have the problem is technology transfer. Basic technology transfer. And I think these three aspects will be considered in the future by younger, like me, researcher.
Thank you very much, Marco, for taking part in this interview. Thank you.
Thank you.